What's up, guys? It's Pastor Risa here.
Hey, guys. Pastor Ken here. Today, we are finishing the last in our series of Merry Christmas to Me with your speaker, Pastor Risa.
This week, we'll be talking about the perfect gift. Not the perfect gift for you or the perfect gift for me, but the perfect gift for God. And throughout this holiday season, and even throughout the year, we can be continuously giving that to Him. So don't miss out on that message. Plus, we have a blog that's going to be pretty special. Pastor Ken, do you want to tell them a little bit about it?
Yeah, Pastor Risa, we've been hearing from you guys who has the best chicken sandwiches, so we decided to get blindfolded, get in a car, and just go taste test them for ourselves. So you're not going to want to miss it. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be a special week, and I cannot wait for you guys to enjoy it with us. Enjoy the rest of the service.
Enjoy.
What a powerful name it is.
What's up, Mount Paran Middle? Pastor Risa here, and we're back for another middle school video, and I'm so excited to hang out with you for a couple of reasons. Number one, okay, basketball season is back in full swing. We got the NCAA, we got the NBA, we got the whole thing happening. And number two, right now as we are filming, it is time. We are 10 days away from Christmas. And Christmas hasn't always been my favorite season, because here's the deal, right? When you're little, right, Christmas is all about all the things that you're going to get. I remember, I don't know how many years ago, it shows how old I am. I remember one Christmas, I got the very first PlayStation. Me and my big brother had to share, but I got the very first PlayStation. But I know, as I've gotten older, right, as I've matured, Christmas is not all about the things I'm gonna receive, but also about the things that I have to give, okay, that I get to give. And finding the perfect Christmas gift is not easy. You know, for this year, like, I would honestly love if Santa would hook me up with a PlayStation 5. You heard me, Santa? PlayStation 5? That's all I want, okay? But those things are so hard to get. And here's the deal. Finding the perfect gift is never easy. It requires you paying attention, it requires some time, and honestly, it requires some investment. A few years ago, and I've talked about this a million times before, I bought my brother what I thought was the perfect Christmas gift, okay? Michael Jordan is one of his favorite basketball players of all time, and the University of North Carolina is his favorite college basketball team. And so one day I was walking at Cumberland Mall, and I found a Michael Jordan UNC basketball jersey. And when I saw that thing, I was like, oh, this is it, right? So I spent some money on it. It doesn't matter how much, but I spent a pretty penny on it. And I brought it home to my brother, and he was all excited. But you know where that jersey is? In my closet, okay, because he never wears it. But last year, on a thrifting site, okay, Vintage Bros, I found this UGA sweatshirt for like 20 or 30 bucks, and my brother wears that thing all of the time. So sometimes the value of something is not always dependent on its cost. So if it's hard to find the perfect gift for a parent, for a sibling, for a friend, can you imagine how difficult it must be to find the perfect gift for God? To find the very thing that He desires most from us? The story in the Bible of three men. Some people call them the wise men. And sometimes we say it's three men, but it may have been more, it may have been less. But the Bible tells us about a group of men that went to go see Jesus, and they brought Him gifts. Let's pick up the story in Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. And it says this. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who had been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." Could you imagine on the day that you were born, a star shows up in heaven? That would be fire, okay? When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chiefs, priests, teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report it to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. That is such an insane scene, that these men were following a star to find where Jesus was born. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All right, so these three gifts, right, these three incredibly special gifts represent three very distinctive things. Number one, back then when you gave someone gold, it was precious, it was valuable, and it was a gift worthy of a king. Frankincense was something that was used in sacrifices to gods as a sign of worship and praise, and myrrh was used in burial practices. So each of these three gifts represented to these men what Jesus was going to do for his people, that he was their king, that he was their God, and that he would eventually die for them. Now you may be asking yourself, okay, so right, so that now God expects me to bring gold and frankincense and myrrh to church all the time? Those are the gifts that he requires of me? And I would like to tell you, no, that is not what God wants you to give to him. What we can do is we can give thanks to God. We can give thanks to Jesus with our words by showing gratitude to him in our conversations with him. Another way to put that is that we can thank him while we pray and while we sing worship songs to him. A second gift that we can give to God is our obedience in loving and honoring and respecting the people around us. What do these two things have in common? How would you define them in the most concise way? We can worship God this Christmas season through our giving and through our thanks, through our actions and through our words. Those two things are simply defined as worship. So the perfect gift this Christmas for you to give to God is your worship. Whether it's through your obedience or through the words that you say to him, this season and in every season, our worship is our gift to God. Love you guys. Cannot wait to see you again next week.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to this week's vlog. It's gonna be exciting.
So me and Pastor Ken are gonna go on a food tasting adventure.
Yeah, so there's been a lot of talk about whose chicken sandwiches are better, Chick-fil-A's, Popeye's, and then somebody said something on one of our Zoom calls about Zaxby's chicken sandwich. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get in the car. We're gonna go blindfolded. Someone else driving, don't worry. Blindfolded with headphones on. We're gonna be taste testing these chicken sandwiches to tell you which is best.
We won't be testing for service. We won't be testing for how quick the food comes out. We won't be testing for somebody saying, you're welcome, or your pleasure, or my pleasure. I'm not really about
your pleasure.
Whatever that is, right? It's all about the flavor of the chicken sandwich. And no sauces, unless it comes already on the sandwich.
Yeah. No extra sauce, no extras. It's the sandwich, how it comes. We're gonna taste test it, describe it to you, and ultimately we're gonna decide which is best.
My money is on Zaxby's.
Actually, the Popeyes is gonna be good, but hey, we will see. Chick-fil-A's classic.
It's a classic. So
are you guys ready?
What I think is gonna happen is they're not gonna be able to tell which sandwich they're eating. They're like, this one's my favorite, but I have no idea which one this one is. Right? Am I right?
No. This guy is gonna know exactly what sandwich he's eating.
All right, let's do this.
Let's go.
All right.
I'm not allowed to let you get injured in front of Angie.
What? I can't hear you. We're riding in my car, so I don't know if I've ever been in the back seat of my own car here.
Okay.
So I'm going Christmas. Are you going Christmas?
I am also going Christmas.
All right, here we go. Actually, it's so weird, like your senses are just all messed up. And I'm gonna know what chicken sandwich I'm eating the second I sink my teeth in.
That's right. Pastor Rice is just jamming. Look at her, man. She's just jamming. All right, so we're in the drive-thru right now of
Chick-fil-A.
And so we're now going to purchase the first sandwich and let them do the taste test. I'm curious as to like what the people in the back are gonna think.
I'm nervous.
I'm nervous too, because I've got to look at the person and order food. It's gonna be awkward, but it's fine. We'll just tell them what we're doing. Boom. Now here's the thing. We can't just give them the bag because they'll know what sandwich it is. They just got to tell us sandwich one, sandwich two, or sandwich three, which one's the best. I got to go ahead and put it. I gotta put it in this, so let me go prep the sandwiches real quick. Here we go, Chick-fil-A. We're handing it to them. Yep, take that. There we go.
Alright.
There we go.
Oh yeah. This is Chick-fil-A.
That's gotta be Chick-fil-A. Hang on. Buttery.
Uh-huh.
The bun is buttery.
Yep.
There's your filet. The pickle. There's the pickle. It's Chick-fil-A.
I just stopped eating this so I have room for
it. Not only did they guess it right, but now they have to remember which sandwich is the best. So we're going to go to stop number two. Here we go. Okay, so what I'm going to do for Ken, I'm going to get a hot sauce packet, I'm going to get a straw, and I'm going to tell him we're also trying the different unsweet teas. So he's going to taste it, and he's going to drink the hot sauce and see his reaction.
Can I get some hot sauce? Yeah. Is that
hot sauce?
Hot sauce.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So it's Texas toast, so that tells me Zaxby's, but let's just double check. It's crispy. Mmm.
Oh, it's a chicken club, right?
I don't know.
Okay, Pastor Ken, we're gonna also do a unsweet tea test. Since I got the unsweet tea from this place as well, I'm just curious. I want you to tell me which one you like, unsweet tea.
This is a good sandwich.
This is a really good sandwich.
It's got to be a Popeye's chicken sandwich with the Zaxby's bread.
This is not the Popeye's chicken sandwich. This is a Zaxby's club.
It's not the best. That's not the best unsweet tea I've had.
Okay, try it. Now just open your mouth. Hang on. Here's a straw.
Get another bite of this.
Alright, I gotta stop. Did you drown?
Did I just drink some sauce?
Okay, so they think that we're going to Popeyes for the third one. But no, we're gonna try the McDonald's what's it called?
Southern style?
Southern style chicken sandwich.
And so excuse me.
We'll see if they think that that's Popeyes or whatever, if they can get the trick, but we'll see what happens.
782 first window.
782, bro, it's like a Ponzi scheme or something. Every time I reach out to touch Risa, she like holds her hand out. Watch this one.
Whoa. I don't want to drink any more of this.
All right, so we're now at Popeyes, but they're taking a minute. They're taking more than a minute, taking a lot of minutes. But we're gonna get the sandwiches too, give them a fourth one, and then make them all confused. So this is gonna be fun.
Ooh.
I don't know what this is.
What? Wait a minute, what's happening? Wait a minute.
I don't like this.
This seems like.
I don't like this at all. Yeah, this is not good.
Mm. That's good. It's saucy. It's got a little sauce.
The chicken is like spongy. Like, it's not good.
No, but that's saucy. This has gotta be. Wait, is this a Popeyes one? It seems kind of flat.
Not a Popeyes.
Sandwich.
Here we go.
Sandwich number four. Number three was terrible.
So we gave them McDonald's, now we're giving them Popeyes.
This is fat. This is like a Popeyes one.
Ooh, it's tasting like mayo, but it's spicy.
That's Popeyes. This other thing was like a Wendy's one or something.
All right, we're gonna go back to the church and let them tell us what they think is the very best.
That's spicy.
First of all, how are you feeling after that?
I am tired.
You know what? I am.
I am tired.
Being blindfolded for that long, it's just weird. And you have the headphones on. You don't know what's going on. Yep. Honestly, I was getting a little car sick.
Oh, that was good. The spread helped. You had to have something with like a little fizz.
A little fizz.
Fizz.
So here's the question. Okay. Let's start naming the sandwiches first, and then we'll rank which ones you like the best.
So the first one, what I'm like 99% sure it's Chick-fil-A.
So I feel like the first one was like the wild card.
Okay.
I feel like the first one was from somewhere else, okay?
Somewhere random.
And I feel like by the time...
No. This guy is gonna know exactly what sandwich he's eating.
Because it had a pickle.
But the third one did not taste like chicken. Like it, like the, like it was like the texture was wrong for the chicken.
That's very true. You know what I'm saying? That's very true.
So you're saying the first one's Chick-fil-A?
Yep. And then he says first one's Wild Card.
Well, from some other place. I don't know. I'm probably overthinking this.
Okay. All right. Second, so let's go to the second one.
Number two, for sure, that was Zaxby's because that chicken sandwich was on Texas toast. Okay.
I agree. Like I've never had that sandwich before. It felt like a chicken club.
It had a good crisp. I kind of liked it.
Yeah, it was a good sandwich. You know? It was a good sandwich.
Well, let me just say this. We had to actually take all the healthy stuff of the tomatoes and the lettuce off of it so that you guys wouldn't like immediately know, you know? But it's fine.
Number three. For me was the random one. I don't know.
The wild card?
I don't know where that was from. That was not real chicken.
I didn't like it. It did have a pickle, and so that's what's kind of throwing me off a little bit. It's almost as though someone planted the pickle to throw us off a little bit. But I'm just saying the number three was Chick-fil-A.
You're just going with it. Just why not, right?
I'm just going with it.
All right, and then number four.
Without a doubt, it's Popeyes.
100%, that big, fat, spicy, like saucy chicken sandwich, greasy. Yep. It was Popeyes.
All right, so let me explain what the first one was, okay? First one was Chick-fil-A. All right. Chick-fil-A. Number two, very simple, Zaxby's, right? Number three, this is the wild card. The wild card was actually, are you ready for it?
What?
McDonald's.
Was it really?
That makes sense. Yeah.
Okay.
That's why it was spongy, you know?
That makes total sense. But, the McDonald's one was the Southern. It was their version of Chick-fil-A, right?
Right, right. And they even like put it in the aluminum foil bag. Total ripoff. Complete ripoff of Chick-fil-A.
But it was trash.
Trash. The fourth one.
It was Popeyes.
It was Popeyes.
Yeah. I got them all right.
All right, so let's get the rankings of which ones they like the best. So here we go. Fourth place right now, show us.
McDonald's.
Interesting. What about you, Pastor?
Same.
McDonald's. Yeah, that was kind of like lame, wasn't it?
Kind of a cheap ripoff.
You can do better, McDonald's. All right, here we go. Third place.
Popeyes.
Really?
Yeah.
No, why?
It's the sauce tasted like mayo.
You don't like
mayo? I do not like mayo.
Pastor Ken, show us third place. What is that? Chick-fil-A. What?
Yeah, Chick-fil-A.
How dare you?
I know. God may be angry with you.
How dare you? Third place. Here we go. Second place, man. He got me off my game. Okay, second place. What is, ooh, Zaxby's.
Zaxby's is number two.
That was actually surprisingly like substantial sandwich.
Yeah.
What was your?
Was there bacon on there?
There was, and cheese.
That was phenomenal.
That's what was throwing me off.
That's what it was. All right, so what about you? What about you? Okay, Zaxby, so y'all agreed on that.
Yes, the Texas toast was actually really delicious, and the chicken was crispy, so I enjoyed that a lot.
And the first place, I think we know by deduction what yours is, Chick-fil-A. Ooh. Now, tell me why you're still holding strong to Chick-fil-A.
Number one, you know what you're gonna get every single time.
Amen.
And it was flavorful. The pickles were just really refreshing today. It's like a little song. I almost ate the whole thing. I had to stop myself.
Yeah.
I did not feel that way about any other sandwich.
I think I had to stop Pastor Ken every time. Like, buddy, you still gotta eat more sandwiches. All right, what about you, Pastor Ken? What's your favorite? Popeyes.
It is definitely Popeyes for me. The chicken was crispy. The bun was substantial too. So it wasn't like one of those like flat buns or whatever. It kind of just felt like good in your hands and tasted delicious. So Popeyes, it's my number one.
I never thought that like sandwiches would be ranked on like handability. That's so stupid.
It just fits perfectly.
I tell you one that didn't fit good in the hand was Zaxby's. That thing was falling apart.
I was like, what am I opening right now? I don't even know.
Oh my gosh.
Hey guys, thank you so much for hanging out with us today. We cannot wait to do another Saturday video with you. Love you guys.
Yeah, we love you guys. See you later. This is all for you.